Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Bo, review for me, please, how we know these two resistors are in series.
Well, is this that thing with the anthropomorphic charge?
Absolutely. A charge which we have given human-like characteristics to, even though charges are clearly not human.
He loves his arcane words.
Anthropomorphism is not arcane.
Sure.
Right. An anthropomorphic charge which moves through resistor 1 has no other choice but to also move through resistor 2. That means those two resistors are in series.
To clarify, every charge which goes through resistor 1 has to also go through resistor 2, and every charge that goes through resistor 2 has to also have gone through resistor 1. In other words, if there is a wire between resistors 1 and 2, that wire provides an alternate path for the anthropomorphic charges to choose, and those two resistors are not in series.
Right.
And when those two resistors are in series, that means the current through resistor 1 is equal to the current through resistor 2. And actually, because the charges also have to go through the battery, the current through the battery is also the same.
What does the epsilon symbol next to the battery mean?
That stands for the EMF of the battery, the electromotive force, or the ideal electric potential difference across the battery.
Right. It's an ideal battery with no internal resistance. Thanks.
What does the T subscript on the current mean?
Oh, that means terminal, as in the current through the terminals of the battery.
Okay. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you, everybody. You know what? Actually, because identifying when circuit elements are in series can be confusing for students, let's take a moment to put 8 example circuits on the screen. Each circuit has 2 resistors and 1 battery. All 4 circuits on the left side of the screen have 2 resistors in series. All 4 circuits on the right side of the screen have 2 resistors which are not in series. I'm not going to take the time to walk through each one of these examples right now, so if you want to pause the video for a moment to look over them for yourself, feel free to do so. If you need more help understanding this, I do have a video which shows color-coded animations of circuits, which I think helps with understanding quite a bit. Now, back to the circuit we were just working with. Actually, you know what? I do want to mention that adding a third resistor into this circuit like this makes it so resistor 1 and resistor 2 are no longer in series. Between resistor 1 and resistor 2, an anthropomorphic charge would have a choice about which path to follow, so that makes it so resistor 1 and resistor 2 are no longer in series. All right, now I really mean it. Back to the circuit we were working with. Billy, tell me what we know about the electric potential differences across all the circuit elements in this circuit with 2 resistors in series with a battery.
Certainly. Because these are ideal wires with 0 resistance, the electric potential difference from the bottom wire to the top wire is the same as the electric potential difference across the battery, and it is the same as the electric potential difference across both resistors, which equals the summation of the electric potential differences across the 2 resistors.
Thank you, Billy. Realize we can get to the same equation by recognizing that if you go all the way around a loop in an electric circuit, the electric potential difference equals 0. For example, starting at point A, which is in the lower left-hand corner of the circuit, and going clockwise through the circuit all the way back to point A, electric potential difference equals final electric potential minus initial electric potential, and if we start and end at point A, both of those are at the same electric potential and at the electric potential at point A, and the differences of those two equals 0 because they're the same. Going up from point A through the circuit, we have the electric potential difference across the battery, which equals the EMF of the battery. And we're going in the direction of the current, therefore we know that EMF or electric potential difference goes up when we go in the direction of the current across a battery. Next, we have the electric potential difference across the 2 resistors. However, we showed last time that when going in the direction of current in a resistor, the electric potential goes down. So we subtract both electric potential differences across the resistors. Moving both of the electric potential differences across the resistors to the other side of the equation gives us the same equation Billy solved for.
I like Billy's solution better.
Billy's solution only took 57 words to explain. Yours took 236. 57 words is a lot fewer than 236. I'll take 57.
I like Mr. P's solution, too.
Yeah.
Either way, they are both correct, so it does not matter to me. Bobby, use Ohm's law with this equation, and let's see what happens.
Okay. Ohm's law states that electric potential difference equals current times resistance. So we can substitute current times resistance in for each of the electric potential differences in that equation. The subscripts for the two resistors are 1 and 2 for the current through and the resistance of each resistor. For the current through the battery, let's use a subscript of T like you did before for the current through the terminals of the battery. For the resistance of the battery, you said it is an ideal battery, so it has zero resistance, right? But that doesn't really make sense.
Let's use a subscript of EQ for the resistance there. That EQ subscript means equivalent. In other words, the current through the battery times the resistance of one hypothetical resistor, which has a resistance equivalent to the resistance of the two series resistors, equals the EMF across the battery. Again, this is just Ohm's law. Electric potential difference equals current times resistance. It's just that the electric potential difference across the battery, the EMF, has the same magnitude as the electric potential difference across a resistor equivalent to the two series resistors.
That makes sense, but
all the currents are equal, so
everybody brought current to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
That means a resistor with resistance equivalent to the two series resistors equals resistance 1 plus resistance 2.
Right. And a more general equation for the equivalent resistance of N, a variable number of resistors in series, equals the summation of the resistances of N, number of resistors. You just add up the resistances of all the series resistors. All right, let's move on to two resistors in parallel. Again, let's use an anthropomorphic charge. An anthropomorphic charge has the choice between paths that go through the two resistors. And then those two paths join back again without going through any other circuit elements. That is why these two resistors are in parallel. Notice then that the electric potential differences across all three of these circuit elements are equal. This is always true of circuit elements which are in parallel. They always have equivalent electric potential differences. Now, because identifying when circuit elements are in parallel can be confusing for students, let's take a moment to put the same 8 example circuits on the screen that I did before. All 4 circuits on the left side have 2 resistors in series, and all 4 circuits on the right side have 2 resistors which are in parallel. Again, I'm not going to take the time to walk through each one of these examples, so if you want to pause the video for a moment to look over them for yourself, feel free to do so. Again, if you need more help understanding this, I do have another video which shows color-coded animations of more circuits, which I think helps with understanding these circuits. Now, back to the circuit we were working with. Billy, use what we know about the two junctions in this circuit, which I have labeled A and B, to derive the equation for the equivalent resistance of two resistors in parallel. Please.
Absolutely. Because conservation of charge states that every charge which goes into a junction will also come out of that junction, the current into a junction equals the current coming out of a junction. Therefore, for junction A, the current through the terminals of the battery equals the sum of the two currents going through the two resistors. From Ohm's law, we know current equals electric potential difference divided by resistance, and we can substitute that in for each current in our previous equation. That means EMF over equivalent resistance equals the sum of the electric potential differences across each resistor divided by the resistance of each resistor.
All the electric potential differences are equal, so
everybody brought electric potential difference to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
that means one resistor with the equivalent resistance of two resistors in parallel equals the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the resistances of the two parallel resistors.
Exactly. And a more general equation for the equivalent resistance of N, a variable number of resistors, in parallel, equals the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the resistances of N numbers of resistors. You just add up the inverses of the resistances of all the parallel resistors and take the inverse of that. Now, looking at the general concept of resistors in series and in parallel, from the equations you can see that when we add resistors in series, the equivalent resistance goes up. And when we add resistors in parallel, the equivalent resistance goes down. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.